Matthews holds the puck in. Makes a move into the middle, missed everybody. Nylander off the boards, faked a slap shot. Backhand pass to Gardner, takes the shot, scores! A deflection in front, I think it's Patrick Marleau that got a piece of the puck, and it's a 1-0 Toronto lead, 2:05 in.
Right from the get-go, the Bruins have tried to take away that pass right there, the cross-seam pass, and Nash gets a little bit of it. That allows Rask to get the piece of it, but how about the play of Matthews here? He kept it in at the line. Now all of a sudden, everybody collapsed back to the net, and this opens up the front, and just great positioning. Look at how aggressive Tuukka Rask was going over to his left, and the tip there. Smart shot by Gardner, and the tip back the other way goes under the five hole as Rask was reaching out to get a piece of it.
Bergeron alone in front, pass didn't get by Ron Hainsey. Corey Krug in for Rick Nash. Brad Marchand back to the blue line, Pastrnak over to Tory Krug, walks in, shoots, stopped on the goal line. A goal line save for Frederik Andersen when he realized the puck had dribbled behind him. Hyman tries to clear the puck. Krejci kept it in once more. Backes is in front. Back to the blue line. They score! Jake DeFrost tipped it in. With just 14 seconds left in the power play, Pastrnak to DeFrost, and it's 1-1.
Just a perfectly placed shot there by Pastrnak, and Jake DeBrusk again, he's had a great series. Look at stick on the ice, and that's all Pastrnak.
Marleau will start out to Marner, tipped off his stick. Tory Krug is back off the boards, got a bounce. Marleau gets the puck to Marner into the slot. Matthews, Marner, Marleau shoots, he scores. Second of the night for Marleau, and the Leafs have the advantage once again.
Well, Maple Leaf Square goes crazy. Marlowe's the recipient of just a great play by Marner. He's been the best player, now a 6-game point streak, and he just stays on this puck. But you have to respect him curling and shooting that one. And instead of shooting it, watch the little curl and drag. For a split second, Rask had to freeze. Then he went over too aggressively, and a good change of pace there by Marleau goes up and past Rask going the other way. That's twice now Rask has been sliding aggressively to his left, and he's been beat the other side.
Gardner with Nash right on him. Krejci there as well. Rick Nash gets the puck to Krejci in front, couldn't get a shot. Hyman turns, shoots, scores! Danton Heinen's first ever playoff point, and it's a big goal that ties the game again.
You know, coaches will often say, don't turn one mistake into two. And here's an errant pass by Gardner. That creates a chance. So he goes after the puck hard. Now he's got a second chance to get it. Loses it not once, but twice down low. Then loses coverage in front. And a quick little turnaround that I don't think Andersen reacted to at all. Heinen at the high part of the slot. Nash just does a no look. Andersen trying to find the puck, and that quick release goes right under the blocker.
It's filtered back onto Backes. Backes a shot that just pops up over the glove hand of Andersen. Dug out there and returned to him by Bergeron. Backes gives it back to Miller. Fires one wide, rebound. Bergeron scores!
The Bruins have been pressing the play for most of the time since the game was tied up here. Miller sees nothing, goes wide intentionally. Berge pulls it from the goal line, behind the goal line actually, pulls it out front and just dumps it in the vacated net by Andersen. That is a huge goal given 36 seconds left in this period.
Mike Goodeye, he shoots it wide on purpose. And how about the skill of Bergeron taking it off the carom on his backhand to the forehand and creating time and space for himself. The illusion, thinking he's going to go to the front of the net to Plekanec. Plekanec loses him. He pulls up. That was sheer hockey sense brilliance by Patrice Bergeron.
Pastrnak is caught leaving his shift. So is his lying. Bergeron's group. Nylander lost control. Polak, Dermott with a shot. Blocked by Pastrnak, but Dermott got the puck again. Takes a shot. He scores! Posted in! Boston tie game. And another young player has his first ever National Hockey League playoff point. Travis Dermott ties the game.
And what a job using his lateral movement to make this possible. He gets the pass from Pollock, and it's a desperation play by Pasternak. But look, he keeps it off his skate to his stick, keeps moving laterally with traffic in front. And for a shooter, that's the best feeling and best noise. Off the post and in. Couldn't have placed it any better. It looked like it might have got tipped along the way just a touch. But Tuukka Rask again beat to that left side. Pasternak dead tired, was caught there for an awfully long shift.
Just over a half a minute of this penalty kick. Nash is coming right at him now. Passes off on the wing. Bergeron into the middle. Dude shoots. Tremendous save. Big rebound lying in front. Anderson's lost his stick. Back up and into the net. Here's a shot from the wing, and Anderson stops that.
These goaltenders come up with some big plays, and there's Anderson in a pile. The rebound's there. Nobody can find it. Anderson lost his stick.
Another chance. Krug, who took the shot, put it to Marchand, and now there's a foot race. Kapanen trying to get position on Marchand. Kapanen alone scores! Finally, Kasperi Kapanen got one to go. A shorthanded goal after a near miss at the other end. 4-3 Toronto.
This game's amazing, isn't it? The back and forth, the drama, the chances at one end, and these goaltenders come up with some big plays, and there's Anderson in a pile. The rebound's there. Nobody can find it. Anderson lost his stick, and while that was going on, Hainsey even grabbed it. And then Marchand can't hold a bouncing puck. Kapanen with a little bit more left in the tank, and you go back to game two. Kapanen off the goal post, missed a chance. Game three, missed a chance. Here, the stop up gets sliding as Rascal the other way, even at the last ditch effort to get the left pad out. Kapanen stays with it to make it a 4-3 game. What a
four against four with 18:54 to go in the third, and off this time it is now Pasternak, and Krugish shot, he scores!
Starts from the draw. Bergeron and Marchand are out there for the Bruins, and it's sort of won by the Maple Leafs, but Krug gets the pass and just simply one times it. No screen in front of Anderson. There's Miller with a pass to Krug, and he zips it. I guess there might have been a moving screen in front of him. He didn't catch all of that. Pierre, how'd you see it?
Well, there was a bit of a screen, but it was the quickness of the shot. The bad news for Toronto, on that side of the ice, Zach Hyman, who's sitting in the box, he takes faceoffs on that side of the ice.
Right back ahead, it's DeBrusk with a step. DeBrusk trying to get it right, he scores!
DeBrusk has been terrific throughout the series. And here he takes advantage of a mistake by Jake Gardiner, number 51, right here. Watch Gardiner. He pivots inside, gets himself out of position. DeBrusk is able to get it to the forehand, and that's a nasty goal against Anderson. He's going to want that over again. But right there, he gets a step in front. Gardiner tries to take the body, neglects to just poke the puck. So DeBrusk gets his opportunity, and it's five hole, and not a very pretty one.
What a great defensive play by Kevin Miller. He forced the turnover. That engaged the drag race between Gardiner and DeBrusk. And for Jake DeBrusk, his fifth goal of the playoffs.
Bergeron out as the forechecker now. Marchand is there. Pasternak is there. Sent ahead and Marleau for Toronto. And then Pasternak. And then back in again, Zaitsev. Game one to Bergeron, out in front, Pasternak to score!
Well, they've been quiet for a while, but in this biggest of moments, watch the pursuit by Marchand. He gets in deep, disrupts the play. Bergeron fishes it out. What patience by Pasternak. But this started way earlier. Here's the Leafs trying to stretch it out. And Chara stays up on Marleau and gets it right back up ice. And off go the Bruins. And Marchand with a hustle. Bergeron with the alertness. And Pasternak with a scorer's touch. Breathing room for Boston.
Yeah, three Leafs behind the icing line. That's just shoddy defensive zone coverage. And an excellent hustle play by Marchand.
By Marner. It's Gardner giving back to Marner. Steps in, tried to fire one. Knocked down by Bergeron. Onto the back it comes to Gardner. Hands back over to Riley and it's worked back in deep. Right back to him it comes now. And it's Riley holding on. Got it back to Bozak once more. Twisted to the front, blocked away by Rask. Tipped back to the outside, Bergeron. Kept alive, and a shot by Conrad is bunted aside by Rask. 2:14 to go, and the Leafs need two. Still a battle for possession in the corner. Came away from Rand Riemsdyk. Taken by Miller, and sent off a stick, and back down. It did look as though it was a Leafs stick that it hit, but apparently not, because it does indeed become an icing. And the faceoff will be back in the Bruins' end of the ice. Battle for by Dermott. At center ice, it plopped on now for Hyman. He stepped in too, but going back toward his Nylander with 90 seconds to go. Poked into some traffic. It's off of Hyman. Settled down and lobbed on back to center ice. Spiked away from Marchand, across by Dermott. Kept alive now by Nylander at center and Raid on to Dermott. Dermott able to connect back up now to Riley. Riley flipped one to the corner. It bounces for Van Riemsdyk. He's able to yank it back along to Cotton. Padre holding in the corner. Cotton has shot! And that hit the outside of the net. Battle four there. Stuck on the outside of the net. They continue to poke away. And then Cotton got it loose. Fed one in front. Picked up there by Riley Nash. Back up to center ice. Weaving his way along as Marchand.
The turnover, down low, hope pass out front. As so often it does, it turns into a chance for the other team, especially when there's an open net.
It will be the Boston Bruins, and